Match game 74, production number 0170, air date to be announced, VTR 22374, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Dick Gautier, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene River.
Thank you very much. I thank you for standing up. How come you didn't stand up?
Oh, I'd already straightened my shorts during the break. Thank you anyway.
I know that. Yes, the studio audience knows all about Ann Elder and thing that she's wearing on her chest. But
what
I think America ought to hear about it because it's most unusual.
Yes.
It was a Christmas gift. Is that
right? One of the girls on Stand Up and Cheer.
A show which you write.
That's right. For Christmas present, she stitched every little sequin on here, and it says Hollywood on there. She was going to put San Bernardino, but I didn't have the room for it.
Thank you. Shall we say hello to our current champ, Kathleen Ellis? Shall we do that?
Hi,
hello, Kathleen Ellis. How are you? You got $6,800. And as time expired last time, she had won another game and started the super match and won the $500 part of that. And now she'll be going for $5,000 on a head-to-head match with one celebrity. And we'll find out which one she will choose right after we pass along this message to you. All right, we're ready to have a go at it now. Kathleen, are you ready?
Ready.
All right, now you've won the $500. That means at this time you will be playing for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Remember to collect. You got to match one celebrity. Has to be an exact match. And which one will you choose?
Bert.
Bert Convy, you are chosen.
Okay.
You get ready to write.
Thank you.
Kathleen will face me. This is the $5,000 question, which will not come out of the envelope. There it is. Soap blank. S-O-A-P blank. Soap blank. Please don't say any answers out loud, audience. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but it may be a rotten answer, which she'll hear and then say it, and then where are you, you know? Okay, Bert's finished. Now, we need an answer from you, Kathleen. How do you fill in the blank? Soap?
Opera.
Soap opera? The audience thinks you're right. We're going to find out right now if you've matched Bert Convy for $5,000. Bert, may we see your answer, please?
Yes, you may. I thought of a lot of things, and I didn't know what to write, but it did come up upside down.
Another player right now, and let's bring on Susan Ulch. I guess maybe the people in the studio audience knows who this is, and I guess all of America knows who this is because his face has been on camera a lot. I know you're not Susan Ulch. I do know you're Mark Goodson.
That's right.
Of Goodson Codman.
Anyway, I came out. First of all, I'd like to get some of the $5,000 back. Actually, I came out. It's a very auspicious occasion, Gene. As you know, in a very short time, this show, Match Game, has become the number one daytime show in all of television.
Yes. Yes, we're all very happy about that. Thank you.
And since you are the star of the show, we tried to find something appropriate to get for you. We thought of an Oscar or an Emmy, but I thought of something that was more appropriate. This is a bag for your needlepoint. Would you mind modeling that for me, Jane?
Listen. Well, now, you know, I live in Cape Cod, and I fly a lot, and that's, you can read so many books.
He does fly a lot. That's,
that's not what I mean. Yes. And I do a lot of needlepoint while I'm flying on the airplane. And I think this is a terrific gift, and I don't care what you think. I love it.
Thank you very much, Jane.
That's beautiful. Well, I think that is just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen, and I'm going to wear it for the entire show.
Yes.
And are you going to get offers?
Yes.
Does this mean the prom is off?
Yes. That is really an elegant thing, and I'm very happy to have it. Now, Susan Alts, we welcome you. Sorry for the delay, but we're very happy to have you here with us, and would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I have two very nice children, Jeffrey and Michael, and I like to skin dive and play bridge, and that's about it.
Yeah, where do you skin dive?
Well, we used to skin dive around Malibu, but now you can't see 2 feet in front of your face.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry that's happening.
Yep, it is.
Yeah, water's getting a little dirty there,
right? See, you still can do it around Catalina.
You can still do it around Catalina.
Right.
You can still do it around Catalina.
Where did you say?
We got
Catalina.
A bus outside leaving for Catalina. No. Well, let's begin this game, shall we? Susan, you know how this goes, don't you? The challenger usually makes the selection, and we ask you to do that.
Okay. My son said, take A for Alch.
Your son said, say A for Alch, is what his son said.
Wait a minute. All my cards have been...
Somebody mark it. Here, Doc.
Oh, thank you.
Do you have some?
Yes, I have some now.
Okay.
Somebody marked his card.
Here we go.
Do anything to get on camera.
Somebody's taking my card.
I'll smash you with my needlepoint bag. Harry said to Bill, what's green and scaly and 10 feet tall? And Bill said, I don't know. And Harry said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your wife. It's a long question. Harry said to Bill, what's green and scaly and 10 feet tall? And Bill said, I don't know. And Harry said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your wife. Just think about something, but don't think too hard. While you're doing that, I'll come over and admire my needlepoint bag. Isn't that beautiful? If you don't have color television, you can't realize it's red and it's got all different things out of there. Are you finished, Doc? Elaine, are you ready?
No.
Now we'll call on Susan Alts. You know, I don't know, and Harry said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your wife. Did you hear the question?
Yes. Okay. I was down to a choice of three, and I'm going to go with kissing.
Kissing. Kissing your wife. That's her answer. And what's yours, Bert?
That big scaly thing was indeed kissing.
Kissing. There's a match for you, Susan Alts. Your kids were right, I guess, so far. Brett.
What were their names? Harry and who?
Harry and Bill.
Oh, well, Harry and his wife were separated, and this big green scaly thing was staying with his wife.
I see.
To you, my friend.
I got news for you. You don't have a friend over there. Dick, what did you say?
Well, I hate big, scaly things kissing, so I just put hugging.
Hugging. All right. No kissing.
You're married to a big, green, scaly thing.
A terrible thing to say. What do you say?
Well, I saw this big, green, scaly thing, and yes? I thought you were talking about some horror movie or something like that, so... this thing was eating his wife.
Aha! Uh-huh. Like a dragon or a monster or something like
yeah.
that. Okay. Richard?
I refuse to answer on the grounds it may incriminate me. However, I did put kissing.
Kissing? There's another match. That's two for you.
Well, let's just say he was on his way to kissing. So while he was on his way, he was crawling up his wife.
I see. Okay.
I was going to kiss.
kiss.
It wasn't a big green scale. It was a small green scaly thing.
No, he had a 12-foot wife. Like
all right, so it's two for you, and in a moment we'll have a question for you. But now, friends, we've got this for you.
GSN presents...
Old Man Periwinkle was just a spontaneous creation.
Get that girl to come over here a little closer.
Dumb Dora, I think that was spontaneous too. Dumb Dora was so dumb, and the audience would just jump right in and say, how dumb was she?
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
Everything we did was spontaneous.
Hello there, shall we have another go at it? Okay, we shall. Now, this is your question in round one. Everybody plays, because this is the second half of round one. Ed took so many vitamins all his life that when he finally died, his blank lived on for another 2 weeks. Ed took so many vitamins all his life that when he finally died, his blank lived on for another 2 weeks. You're finished. You're the best.
All
right.
Not all necessarily. Washed. Quick is not necessarily terrific.
That's true.
You know, I always thought you were blind. I put my glasses on and found out you really have dark hair.
Yes, I am a brunette. Turning a little bit silver in some spots now around the temples.
But just among the gold, dear.
Yes. What are you doing out here? Yeah. Oh, would you like a little help? Ed took so many vitamins all his life that when he finally died, his blank lived on for another 2 weeks.
What did he take the vitamins for?
Well, for a friend.
For a friend? What? That cleared
okay.
up.
Kathleen, Ed took so many vitamins all his life that when he finally died, his blank lived on for another 2 weeks.
Okay, I think his body lived on. He died, you know, his soul died, but his body lived.
Yes, you don't have to explain it. I understand what your body is.
Is she a religious fanatic?
Yes, it's a great thought. Her answer is body, Bert. What's yours?
Well, I said he died, but his liver lived on.
There's a good answer. That's a good answer. Brett, what do you say?
My liver died about 6 years ago.
But your body lives on.
Well, I'm not too sure about that. That's a dumb answer. But it's all right, because I said...
Oh, Kathleen scores one with body there.
Well, all right, if only your mind could live, then you'd really be in good shape. Here's her liver.
Liver. Liver was the answer. All right. Now, I'm sorry that you didn't understand the question, did you?
Uh-huh.
Oh, you did understand it. Did you understand that some part of his body was what the thing implied, really, or... No. Okay. Well, what did you show the people...
But after Richard cleared it up and said his friend lived on, that made it perfectly clear.
Yes, that's it. You see? So that's her answer.
So it's his fault.
It's his... That was a dumb answer.
Gee, she's smart as a whip, isn't she?
All right, Richard.
Try. Getting better and better.
Yeah, you do indeed. Boy, I'll bet you'll try and follow that act.
Here. Don't give her anything sharp.
Liver.
Liver is the answer. Body's the answer Kathleen looking for. After he died, his blank lived on for another 2 weeks. What do you say, Anne?
Well, I know that vitamins make you very strong and everything, so I thought that his muscles just sort of lived on.
His muscles lived on for another 2 weeks. Okay, there's some logic to that, too. Now, let's move on to round two, folks. Susan, would you make a selection?
I'll go with A again.
A for Alch. It's 2-1 in favor of the challenger at this moment. Bert, you will not play, and Richard, you will not play. Before the actor goes on stage, he always kisses his blank for good luck. This is an actor. Before the actor...
Any actor or a particular actor?
No particular actor we have in mind. Before the actor goes on stage, he always kisses his blank for good luck.
Oh, I know what it is, and I can't think of it.
Draw a picture of it.
It's like it goes like that. Oh, no, that's wrong. Wait a minute.
It certainly is.
There are people who are going to be able to explain it, and everyone...
That's the expression.
I see. Okay, that's... They're all finished now. Now, Susan, we call on you. Before the actor goes on stage, he always kisses his blank for good luck.
I'm going to go with mirror.
Mirror? He kisses his mirror. I knew he liked his mirror, but I didn't know he kissed his mirror before he went on stage. Brett, what do you say he kissed?
Oh, isn't he writing?
No.
Oh, okay, honey.
Well, I don't know. I can't even write. I can't
no,
write that.
No, I said it was mitvah, but it isn't mitvah. What are those things that Jewish people have on the front?
A mezuzah.
That,
a mezuzah.
Yes.
A mitvah.
Yes, we know what you meant.
Did you say mezuzah?
No, she didn't say mezuzah. She said mirror.
Okay, I'll tear my answer up there and say whatever she said.
Tear your body up, would you, and put it in the slot there. Dick, what did you say?
I know from my own experience being a supreme narcissist, it's mirror.
Mirror is a man. Okay. Now, how about you, my dear?
How about me?
Yes.
See, when Brett says something like that, nobody gets honored for being a dummy and all that, right?
Oh, yeah, we do.
You do?
Oh, we do a lot, yes.
Okay, well, all the actors I've ever worked with have come by and said something, and then they give me a little kiss, their leading lady.
Kiss the leading lady. How sweet.
How does that work?
Then they kill you on stage.
In the boys in the band?
How did that work?
It didn't work in the boys in the band. They kissed the cowboy there.
Was that a musical?
What did you say, my dear?
Well, this is really sickening.
It is.
Yes,
don't
it
show
is.
It then if it's sickening.
Well, it's not that sickening.
Oh, all right.
He always kissed his mother's picture.
Oh, that's sickening.
That's sickening.
Isn't that sickening, folks? That is sickening.
Wow.
No, that's not. That's a kind of a sweet thought there.
I thought.
The score at this moment is 3-1. You scored two times with that, Susan, right? Once. I beg your pardon. Once. It was 2-1, and now it's 3-1. And I don't know what the score is, but I'll figure it out in a moment or so, and then you'll come back, and I'll tell you what the score is.
Today's consolation prizes are Eureka Canister Vacuum Cleaner with powerful fan jet motor. Convenient 7-piece tube pack. This Eureka cleans everything from rugs to curtains. And heavy-duty Glamorine Rug Shampoo. The rug cleaner that's the efficient, easy way to clean or brighter rugs from Glamorine. And a supply of Airwick Solid, including rose, natural, and lemon scents in beautiful decorated colors. Airwick works 24 hours a day to help eliminate odors. We'll carry on with the blanks on Match Game 74 in 60 seconds.
Here we are. 3-1 is the score in favor of the challenger. And we go to the second half of our second and final round. Kathleen must score two matches to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Then we go to tiebreaker if that happens. Three, however, will win another game for you, Kathleen. Last time you matched Brett, so you will not participate in this. Everyone else will. Wilma's kitchen was really a mess because she forgot to blank the chicken before she cooked it. Wilma's kitchen was really a mess because she forgot to blank the chicken before she cooked it. All right.
I'll throw it
away. What is that called? The upper tier is ready. Is your... Yes. Okay. All right, we're all set over there. Kathleen, think about it now. Wilma's kitchen was really a mess because she forgot to blank the chicken before she cooked it.
She forgot to pluck it?
Pluck it. Two plucked chickens will tie the score. Three will win the game. What do you say, sir?
Well, Kathleen and I are on the same wavelength as usual. Pluck!
Pluck the chicken. All right. And Dick Gautier.
I had another image in mind, and that's empty the chicken.
I see.
It's a little messier, yes. But what the heck, eh?
It's a more polite word than eviscerate, I would say.
Yeah.
And how about you? Do
Don't
you
mix me up with these big words.
Okay.
It was a mess because she forgot to pluck it.
Pluck the chicken. That ties the score. Now, if you match either Richard or Anne, Kathleen, you will win another game.
Good gravy.
She forgot to blank the chicken before she cooked it. What do you say to that?
She forgot to clean the chicken.
Clean the chicken.
You know the expression, clean the chicken.
Match? That is a match. She not wins the game. Congratulations. Okay, congratulations. There's another $100 for you. And now, Susan, I'll say goodbye to you. We've got a gift for you backstage, together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game 74. Susan Alt, there she goes. All right. Now, Kathleen, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. blank mate. Now, you know how the answers go, 500, 250, and 100. Three celebrities can give you a little help. Choose them one at a time.
Bert
Convy, how do you fill that in?
I would say first mate.
First mate is his answer.
Dick
Gautier?
Ship's mate. A shipmate, rather.
Shipmate. Okay, there's two.
Brett.
What do you say?
How about soulmate?
Yeah. Soulmate is her answer. Okay.
Don't try like that. You soulmate. Know I'm very insecure about my answers anyway.
First mate and shipmate. You may choose one of those or give us your own answer. What would you like to do?
I'm going to say first mate.
First mate is the answer that Bert gave you. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where may we see the $100 response? Paper mate. That's a commercial thing, isn't it? All right, still looking for first mate. Here's the $250 response. Playmate. Oh, that's another good one that none of us thought about, did we, folks? All right, last chance for first mate. Here is the $500 response. Checkmate. Sorry about that. Actually, now that you see them, they're all pretty good answers. Okay, Kathleen, you've picked up a little more money. You're up to $11,900. You'll meet another player and play another game. First is message.
No, you're not hallucinating.
We're going to see our champion next time we get together. We've said goodbye to her, and it's time to say goodbye together with a very warm thank you to all of these people. Of course, we hope all of you will stay tuned for Tattletales with Bert Convy there and
thank
his
you,
group of lovable kooks. They're a grand bunch, as these are. You are a grand bunch. And next time we get together, we will have this assortment of zanies.
Pat Harrington, Brett Summers, Nick C. Russell, Fanny Flagg, Richard Dawson, and Joanne Wally.
Team Raven from Match Game 74, join us next time. Thank you.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Scottman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.
I think that is just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen, and I'm going to wear it for the entire show.
Yes.
And are you going to get offers?
Yes.
Does this mean the prom is off?
Yes. That is really an elegant thing, and I'm very happy to have it. Now, Susan Alts, we welcome you. Sorry for the delay, but we're very happy to have you here with us, and would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I have two very nice children, Jeffrey and Michael, and I like to skin dive and play bridge, and that's about it.
Yeah, where do you skin dive?
Well, we used to skin dive around Malibu, but now you can't see 2 feet in front of your face.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry that's happening.
Yep, it is.
Yeah, water's getting a little dirty there,
right? See, you still can do it around Catalina.
You can still do it around Catalina.
Right.
You can still do it around Catalina.
Where did you say?
We got
Catalina.
A bus outside leaving for Catalina.
No.
Well, let's begin this game, shall we? Susan, you know how this goes, don't you? The challenger usually makes the selection, and we ask you to do that.
Okay. My son said take A for Alch.
Your son said say A for Alch is what his son said.
Wait a minute. All my cards have been...
Somebody marked it. Here, Dawg.
Oh, thank you.
Do you have some?
Yes, I have some now.
Okay.
Somebody marked his card.
Here we go.
Do anything to get on camera.
Somebody's taking my card.
I'll smash you with my needlepoint bag. Harry said to Bill, what's green and scaly and 10 feet tall? And Bill said, I don't know. And Harry said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your wife. That's a long question. Harry said to Bill, what's green and scaly and 10 feet tall? And Bill said, I don't know. And Harry said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your wife. Just think about something, but don't think too hard. While you're doing that, I'll come over and admire my needlepoint bag. Isn't that beautiful? If you don't have color television, you can't realize it's red and it's got all different things out of there. Are you finished, Doc? Elaine, are you ready?
No.
Now we'll call on Susan Alch. You know, I don't know, and Harry said, I don't either, but it's blanking your wife. Did you hear the question?
Yes. Okay. I was down to a choice of three, and I'm going to go with kissing.
Kissing. Kissing your wife. That's her answer. And what's yours, Bert?
That big scaly thing was indeed kissing.
Kissing. There's a match for you, Susan Alch. Your kids were right, I guess, so far. Brett.
What were their names? Harry and who?
Harry and Bill.
Oh, well, Harry and his wife were separated, and this big green scaly thing was staying with his wife.
I see.
Speak to you, my friend.
I got news for you. You don't have a friend over there. Dick, what did you say?
Well, I hate big, scaly things kissing, so I just put hugging.
Hugging, all right. No kissing in here.
You're married to a big, green, scaly fish.
A terrible thing to say. What do you say?
Well, I saw this big, green, scaly thing, and yes? I thought you were talking about some horror movie or something like that, so... this thing was eating his wife.
Uh-huh. Like a dragon or a monster or something like
yeah.
that. Okay. Richard?
I refuse to answer.
And started the super match and won the $500 part of that. And now she'll be going for $5,000 on a head-to-head match with one celebrity. And we'll find out which one she will choose right after we pass along this message to you. All right, we're ready to have a go at it now. Kathleen, are you ready?
Ready.
All right, now you've won the $500. That means at this time you will be playing for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Remember to collect, you got to match one celebrity. Has to be an exact match. And which one will you choose?
Bert.
Bert Convy, you are chosen.
Okay.
You get ready to write.
Thank you.
Kathleen will face me. This is the $5,000 question, which will not come out of the envelope. There it is. Soap blank. S-O-A-P blank. Soap blank. Please don't say any answers out loud, audience. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but it may be a rotten answer, which you'll hear and then say it, and then where are you, you know? Okay, Bert's finished. Now, we need an answer from you, Kathleen. How do you fill in the blank? Soap?
Opera.
Soap opera? The audience thinks you're right. We're going to find out. Right now, if you've matched Bert Convy for $5,000, Bert, may we see your answer, please?
Yes, you may. I thought of a lot of things, and I didn't know what to write, but it did come up upside.
Match game 74, production number 0170, air date to be announced, VTR 22374, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Dick Gautier, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene River.
Thank you very much. I thank you for standing up. How come you didn't stand up?
Oh, I'd already straightened my shorts during the break. Thank you anyway.
I know that.
Lovely lady?
Yes, the studio audience knows all about Ann Elder and the thing that she's wearing on her chest, but
what
I think America
on his chest?
Ought to hear about it because it's most unusual.
Yes.
It was a Christmas gift, is
that's
right?
Right.
One of the girls on Stand Up and Cheer.
A show which you write.
That's right. For Christmas present, she stitched every little sequin on here, and it says Hollywood on there. She was going to put San Bernardino, but I didn't have the room for it.
Thank you. Shall we say hello to our current champ, Kathleen Ellis? Shall we do that?
Hi,
hello,
champ.
Kathleen Ellis, how are you? You got $6,800. And as time expired last time, she had won another game. Excited, right?
Right.
Okay. Well, listen, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to introduce another player right now, and let's bring on Susan Ulch. The audience knows who this is, and I guess all of America knows who this is because his face has been on camera a lot. I know you're not Susan Ulch. I do know you're Mark Goodson.
That's right.
Of Goodson Codman. So what I want to know is, what the heck are you doing out here?
Tell you why I came out. First of all, I'd like to get some of the $5,000 back. Actually, I came. It's a very auspicious occasion, Gene. As you know, in a very short time, this show, Match Game, has become the number one daytime show in all of television.
Yes. Yes, we're all very happy about that. Thank you.
And since you are the star of the show, we tried to find something appropriate to get for you. We thought of an Oscar or an Emmy. But I thought of something that was more appropriate. This is a bag for your needlepoint.
Are you kidding?
Now, would you mind modeling that for me, Jane?
Listen. Well, now, you know, I live in Cape Cod, and I fly a lot, and that's, you can read so many books.
He does fly a lot. That's,
that's not what I mean. Yes. And I do a lot of needlepoint while I'm flying on the airplane. And I think this is a terrific gift, and I don't care what you think. I love it. Thank you very much, Jane. That's beautiful.
Oh, that's so funny.
Thank you so much, Mark.